Now, when it comes to camping from the car, I am all about bringing some of those luxury gear items that make my time in camp a bit more comfortable and enjoyable. Especially for the fact that very often I am camping with my wife and my kids, and they absolutely appreciate having many of those luxuries that just make camp life more enjoyable, especially in the evenings and night when it gets a bit colder than maybe you were expecting it to. Now, I like to think that I'm a pretty simple guy when it comes to my needs for a camping trip, but I also really enjoy convenience with the gear that I bring with me. I mean, I've got my car, all of that extra space, I might as well bring some of those things that just add some convenience and comfort and more enjoyable aspects to being out on a trip. And one piece of gear that has become a staple for my car camping trips is a power station. This right here is the Anker Solex C1000 power station that is fairly new to me, but I've been using several different types of power stations over the past few years, and Anker Solex is actually sponsoring this video today. So we're gonna dig into some of the specs and details of this C1000 power station. But in general, what a power station provides for me from a convenience standpoint is the ability for me to, one, power my 12-volt fridge. I have completely stepped away from using coolers on my camping trips, and I've got a 12-volt fridge that makes it so much easier for me to keep my food and drinks nice and cold and not have to manage ice in the backcountry. We'll talk about that more here in a second, but this power station, it just provides the ability for me to power all of the things that I want to keep charged, especially when I'm out with my family. We've got iPads that the kids bring to be able to watch movies in the tent. Then I've also got cameras and things that when I'm out on a trip, I might be charging those to be able to enjoy my trips a bit more. I might have all sorts of different types of items here. And with this, you have 11 different ports. So you've got 6 AC ports. You've got 4 USB, 2 of them are USB-C, 2 are USB-A. So I need to charge my microphone. I can plug that in. I can also plug in my little Insta360 and get that charged through the USB. Maybe I've got an iPad that I'm doing some reading or watching a TV show or a movie on. But then I've also got my 12-volt car plug here for me to plug my fridge into, and I can do all of that charging simultaneously on the device here. It is seriously fantastic. Now, the specific power outputs for each of these is on your USB-C, you have a 100 watt output and a 30 watt output, and then pretty standard for USB-A. And then these 6 AC outlets are that 110 power, with the inverter being able to put out a total power wattage of 1800 watts. So this will essentially power pretty much anything that you would bring with you on a camping trip. Now, as the name implies, with the C1000, the watt hour capacity of this unit is 1056 watt hours, which is a nice sweet spot for me of capacity for a weekend camping trip to power my fridge, to charge all the things that I need. But if I'm going out for an extended period of time, I've got the option of pairing this with a 200 watt solar panel from Anker to be able to top things off, keep it nice and charged while I'm out there, because this has a solar input of up to 600 watts of charging. So when you've got that much solar coming in, this thing's gonna charge up really, really fast. But if you're using that 200 watts to basically top things off and just keep it at a steady state, then that's going to be plenty of charging for what you need. But if you do deplete the battery and you need to charge it super fast, the AC input will charge this in less than an hour. It's about 58 minutes of time for you to completely charge this from 0 to 100%. This is a really small form factor, which I also enjoy. It makes it possible for this to just be a much more enjoyable piece of gear because it's more mobile, but it has all of that power that you want, that, again, 1056 watt hours really makes a difference. You also have a light bar here on the top. It's gonna be hard to see with the camera being here in the daylight, but you've got 3
different power modes. But then if you push and hold the button here, it's gonna go into an SOS mode. So there is that opportunity to use that way also. This just has everything that you need from a power station and not a bunch of extras as well. And I really, really enjoy that from the C1000. So if you wanna learn more about the Anker Solex C1000, I've got a link down in the video description to see current promotion as well as just get more information to see whether or not you think this is a good option for you for your camping needs. But since we're talking about a fridge and how it pairs with this, let's move on to that piece of luxury gear. Now, as I said earlier, one of my favorite pieces of luxury camping gear is a 12 volt fridge and used in conjunction with the power station because you do have to have these two items for it to function, but it is so much better than having to manage ice in a cooler. I hate that aspect of your cooler warming up over time, the ice melting, everything inside of the cooler getting soaking wet. It's just not a fun thing. And the 12 volt fridge makes it possible for you to have consistent temperature inside of the fridge and stuff doesn't get soaking wet. It keeps it at that temperature that is safe for food. Sometimes I get worried on really hot summer camping trips that my cooler is actually not keeping my food at a safe temperature. And with the fridge, I'm able to ensure that that takes place. This is also a much smaller form factor in a lot of ways than some coolers, especially when you look at like a Yeti, for example, that is a much bigger piece of gear than it needs to be. But in order for it to keep ice cold, ice is cold. In order to keep food cold, you have to have a lot of insulation. And this is just seriously a way more convenient way to go. And when it's paired with your power station, I'm able to monitor everything and make sure that the fridge is functioning, that it's at temperature. I can pull up the app on my phone for the power station to see what kind of draw I'm getting from the fridge to see how long the power station is also going to last. And then do I need to plug in my solar panel to be able to top this off? It makes it really easy to monitor things to make sure that this stays functional for the duration of my trip. So I would say of all of the pieces of gear that I have acquired for making my camping trips more enjoyable, my wife would also agree with this one. The 12 volt fridge is hands down one of the best camping upgrades and luxury items that we have moved to in recent years with our camping. Now, another really enjoyable piece of luxury camping gear is this here, the Ignik Fire Can. This is a propane fire pit, and it provides so much convenience for like instant warmth when you're out on a camping trip. Sometimes you've got really cold mornings, you're waiting for the sun to come up over a ridge, and especially with my kids, this is such an easy way for me to get warmth and warm them up and help them enjoy themselves more in the morning than trying to light a fire that then just becomes a smoke pit and a problem. This is instant warmth. I can turn it on and off, and it's really easy and convenient to carry on a car camping trip because it doesn't take up a lot of space. I pair it with the Ignik 5-pound propane tank, growler propane tank. This lasts for a very, very long time, easily for a weekend camping trip. I also take this to do my cooking with my propane 2-burner stove. That ability to turn on and off at any time when you've got fire restrictions and you can't actually have wood burning fires, I can still bring this in a lot of cases because I'm able to turn it off without any problem as well. And it doesn't have all of the smoke issue that you typically get from your standard type of fire. So if you don't want all of that nasty smoke and you just want more of a clean, easy way to warm up in the morning or the evenings, do some s'mores. And even with this one here, the Fire Can Deluxe, I've got the ability to do some grilling on this. So hold that thought. So with the Fire Can Deluxe here, you've got this insert that you're able to set down on the inside of this and you're able to do some grilling and cooking on here, hot dogs, chicken, small steak, like really convenient way for you to get a multi-use product here for when you're headed out and not just use as a fire pit. I love the convenience of this. It's one of my favorite pieces to take on a camping trip. All right, now we're starting to get
extra bougie with the items that we're talking about. This is luxury, right? Well, this is a heated blanket, and this is another benefit of having the power station, because I'm able to plug a heated blanket into the power station and get nice and cozy inside of the tent. Or if I'm just sitting around camp, maybe I don't have a campfire, or I'm just extra cold, this is a really nice way to take the chill off and just enjoy some of those colder evenings and mornings around camp. It's convenient, it's just luxury. It's something that adds that little touch of detail to being a bit more comfortable in the backcountry. And I'll speak for my wife and say that this is something that makes a huge, huge difference in her experience, but also for my kids when they just don't want to be cold on those days that are in the fall or early spring, and we're trying to get out and enjoy being outside together as a family. So worth carrying to be able to enjoy yourself just that much more. Now, the last piece of gear we'll talk about is one of my favorite things because it provides a really good sleeping experience. And it's what I am sitting on, which is a self-inflating foam core sleeping pad. This is nice and thick, it's super comfortable. It is just more bed-like than pretty much any other sleeping pad that I've been able to use. And it's way better for you to be sleeping on than a cheap, uninsulated air mattress that pretty much you're guaranteed to develop a leak in, and your butt and your body just ending up on the cold ground. I can think of so many occasions of myself and my wife personally being on a cheap air mattress and having a cold night of sleep, but also just the pad gets a leak in it and you end up on the ground. It's so frustrating when it's 2 o'clock in the morning, the thing is not holding air, and you've got 2-3 more nights of managing that when you're out on a camping trip. These self-inflating foam core sleeping pads are so much more comfortable. They provide you a lot of insulation value. This one, in fact, from Ampex, has an R value of 9. And it's able to achieve that because it has all of that foam on the inside of the pad. So it provides comfort, it provides an insulation value to keep you nice and warm and sleep comfortable. And it is not that much additional bulk for you to carry in your car out on your trip. It's a much more reliable sleeping experience. It's more comfortable than those cheap, uninsulated vinyl type of air mattresses. And I think they're a better option than using your small, compact, ultralight air mattress or sleeping pad for your backpacking. So if I lay down on this, I know that I'm gonna enjoy myself so much more because I am more comfortable, higher off the ground, have that insulation value, and I'm just gonna get more of a bed-like experience. Like this air mattress, this sleeping pad here, seriously feels like my bed at home. And same with this one. This is nice. the things we do with our gear to enjoy ourselves out on a camping trip. Anyway, thank you so much for watching today, guys. If you're not subscribed to the channel, please do subscribe. Again, thank you to Anchor Solix for sponsoring this video today. Check out the link for the C1000 down in the description. Really, really cool power station, and I think it's worth checking out. But we'll catch you guys on the next one. We'll see you later.